was maybe I can do it. You think we'll do the lowering on the whole year? Yeah, he told me that.
Because he said, I asked him, like, oh, I assumed you have to then. I must have updated it. You can put it in here.
Just give me a little bit of this.
I almost stopped by.
Yeah.
for several things.
How you doing there, buddy?
How's it going?
Not too bad.
Good.
Good, how y'all doing?
Good.
have a couple of these in the box.
Yeah.
Did you try to hook up to them?
Yeah. It was too tall.
To fit.
Yours a little bit bigger.
A 12 volt battery needs to hold over 12 volts. So that's test number one. The best test you can do is crank the engine and watch this.
I put these on YouTube.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. You wouldn't believe how many people watch them.
I'm the only show producer in the sport that's in the SEMA Hall of Fame.
Huh? You're the what now?
The only show producer that's in the SEMA Hall of Fame. Like nobody in Good Guys, nobody in NSRA. You know what SEMA is?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I got in the Hall of Fame in 12, so.
Good.
That was a big deal.
Yep. You know, you never know who you're going to meet down here at these places.
Yeah. In 1982, I ran 100 shows.
Oh, really?
In 1 year. That was my car, the Red Baron.
That one's yours?
Yeah.
I've seen that.
I sold it to Speedway Motors Museum in Lincoln, Nebraska.
Yep.
It's on display there. Huh?
I've seen it.
Oh, you've been there?
I've seen that car.
Okay.
Yeah, I know what that car is.
It was built in 1968.
Yeah. So you're Bob?
I am.
All right, I'll probably catch you back through here when I come back, maybe sometime this weekend. I might not catch you today, but I'll probably catch you one day before the weekend's over.
I'll be here.
All right, buddy.
Thank
you. Have a good one.
play one. It's the amount of song.
11 songs. Yeah, just take those. And then that way. No, those are 14, but I mean, you can just cut it. Yeah, we'll just cut it. So, that's great. So that, and that's 55. Yeah, we do cards. We're going to walk over, though. We're doing our like, card sales with Danny, so we'll just go over there.
We have a
good. How you guys doing?
I'm good.
Pretty good. Having a good time out here today?
Oh, yeah.
Where y'all from?
Just a little bit north of Charlotte. We're in Mooresville, North Carolina.
Yeah.
Thank you.
recommend it more.
He had some details on there. Looks like it may have been taken out pretty easily. It was for sale. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. It's another display, so can't help you there.
Thank you. Thank you. You know who's got the keys to it?
Yeah,
that's a good looking car.
Sure is. I was noticing the unusual way that the trunk support is.
Yeah, that's neat.
I haven't seen that before. But, I wonder if that was a kid or just something custom made.
I don't know. I mean, as far as part of it, don't look too hard to make other than that slide down right there. But really, that wouldn't be too hard to make, I don't think. But yeah, pretty neat.
I was just wondering if it was what, like a plunger to keep it. Because one of the problems with these, the time you put soundproofing in the lid,
yeah,
and the original thing, that was definitely that would bend like a presser or something. So you got to be careful closing the lid. If you pull down even a little bit, it'll bend that original support that's in the 32. It looks like it's a little more robust.
Yeah, it does.
It must have a damper or something to keep it from slamming shut.
Yeah, no telling. But it's nice, I can tell you that.
Yeah.
It's a good looking car and done right.
Bolts into the stock car. Well, then southern connectors.
Yeah, if you already have one of their hydroponic front, if you can get the rear. Yeah, the building department to see what they would say regarding that. I don't know. I'd have to do a quote.
The
other thing I
could
think would be to contact someone racing.
Yeah.
How you doing, bud?
Pretty good. Yourself,
man? Not too bad.
Getting a good shot at everything?
Huh?
Getting a good shot at everything?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'll put this stuff on YouTube.
Yeah.
Cool. Thank you. You gotta watch out for your go cars here, buddy. You know what? Pretty bad when you go to an outright event, you gotta worry more about the.
Good to hear too.
Yeah.
It's not a dime.
Yeah,
problem. try to keep it going, you know?
Right. What kind of car are you going to get?
You got to set it to your left
side. Where you? That'd be cool as shit.
That ain't half as cool as that chair you got there.
Oh.
A lot of things, isn't it?
It's almost there. What's that? Is it? It's almost here. How about
was up here. It didn't rain yesterday. Had a little bit of rain. This is my, I'm going to say this, it's my nephew.
Oh yeah.
So I'll do an advertising for the show or something?
No, I put all this stuff on YouTube.
Yeah, we might get it.
doing, everybody? I do this, put it on YouTube.
Oh, okay. Let me know if you need anything.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You can go to theoldcarshow.com.
What is it?
You can go to oldcarshow.com on YouTube. It'll link you to YouTube.
Okay.
You
see it on there.
Yep. It'll probably be, you know, you probably won't see it up there until about probably 2 or 3 weeks. So,
oh, wow.
2 weeks.
Yeah.
Just because of time it takes to edit it and stuff.
But, so you do this, you just video
people like these flop meets and stuff.
Yeah?
Yeah. I've been them on different, you know, different channels and stuff, and people love them. And I've been putting them on that channel since this year, but yeah. They love these swap meets and parts places.
Yeah.
All these, they got a lot of attention.
Cool.
Yeah.
Good for everybody.
Yeah, it's good for everybody. And I enjoy doing it. It gives me something to do. And I've been actually recording the car show out here for about 20 years now.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So I've got a lot of video of all that stuff and the cars.
Yeah.
I probably got every car out there that's been out there in the past 20 years.
Wow.
Yeah. Yep. Spent a lot of years taking pictures of them. And then video, you know, as the video got better, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because a lot years ago, the video really wasn't that good, you know what I mean? And actually, the pictures wasn't that good compared to today.
Yeah, I mean,
there's no comparison to, and I had top of the line cameras back years ago, and none like these new ones.
Technology will just improve everything.
Yeah. So do you make this stuff or?
Yes, sir.
That's cool. I've met a lot of people in here that make their stuff, you know, pretty much make it all, and that's neat.
Yeah.
And it's good it's made here.
Yes. Yes.
Anytime it's American made, it's great. Especially somebody who's not some great big company that, you know.
Oh, yeah.
It takes millions and millions of dollars to do, but
yeah, and it's fun making car parts and coming to shows and talking to guys and
yeah. Yeah. And you got your stuff really displayed nice too. It looks your booth looks nice, you know.
Yeah, it's not just a bunch of parts strewn on the table.
Yeah, that's kind of what I'm getting at.
Yeah.
So how long you been doing this?
This probably about 15 years now.
Really?
I started out like everybody else, making a few parts, going to swap meets.
Yeah.
And recently, you know, one show and then two shows. And it's half a dozen big shows a summer.
Yeah. Well, it looks like you're doing pretty good. You've been spending a lot of time doing it, it seems like.
Yeah.
It's an art, you know.
Trying to keep up with what people are going to buy and what people are interested in.
Yeah. Yeah, I actually do jewelry repair for a living, and you know, people wouldn't believe it, but that business has changed so much, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, because prices of gold. And just the economy's changed it. And a lot of mom and pop businesses are gone nowadays, you know?
Yeah, that's the sad part.
And people don't realize that, but they're gone.
And they have artillery, you know? Nobody wants to buy it. Nobody wants to take it over.
Hell, you're the one
working on a small business and you keep getting the water every week.
Yeah, it is. A lot of dedication. That's
a good word for it.
Yeah, people are not real. That's a good name, Mary.
Oh,
thought it'd be cool to have a rat rod. I really did think about a rat rod.
How you doing, everybody?
How are you today?
Not too bad.
Fancy little gadget.
Yeah.
Is that a GoPro?
Yeah.
Okay.
With a gimbal on it.
Really?
Yeah. Then it just kind of keeps it smooth. You know what I'm saying?
That's really neat.
Keeps it from getting out of control too much. It keeps the film possibly.